बारे में इन जनरल थोड़ा डिस्कस किया था एंड अबाउट द प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स। Now eukaryotic cells, they are more complex as compared to prokaryotic cells. As we have discussed earlier that prokaryotic cells, they lack many organelles that are present in the eukaryotic cells, and that's because prokaryotic cells are less complex, whereas the eukaryotic system is more complex and multicellular in design. So that's why there are presence of many organelles here that are absent in prokaryotic cells. Also the eukaryotic cells, they have a nucleus which is surrounded by nuclear envelope, whereas the prokaryotic cells, they don't have nuclear envelope. The genetic material, the DNA, is scattered inside the cytoplasm. So first of all, let's discuss about the eukaryotic cells. Now plant eukaryotic cells, we have the plant cells and the animal cells. Now the difference between the plant cells and animal cells is, the major difference is that the cell wall is present here, whereas in animal cells the cell wall is absent. Then second, plastids are present here, whereas plastids are not present here. Also here we have large vacuole that are present here, large vacuoles are absent. Apart from these differences, there are the organelles which are present in both plant and animal cells are same. And what are those organelles? The first is your ER, that is endoplasmic reticulum, then Golgi apparatus, then lysosomes, ribosomes, mitochondria, and the envelope that is surrounding the cell, that is cell membrane. Now we'll discuss about these organelles one by one. First of all, let's discuss about the outer membrane which surrounds the cell, that is your cell membrane. Now cell membrane is, it is a phospholipid bilayer. Phospholipid bilayer. Phospho means that there is a presence of phosphate group, and then there is lipid moiety, and bilayer, it's because there are two such layers are present. How it is present? Now this is the phospholipid bilayer, because there's two such layers, that's why it is bilayer. Now what are these? There are two regions that are there in the membrane. One is hydrophobic, the other is hydrophilic. This one is your hydrophilic region. Hydrophilic means water loving. So the head that is present, it is hydrophilic, whereas this is the tail and your tail is hydrophobic. Hydrophobic means water repelling. Then apart from these phospholipids, there are presence of proteins. There are two category of proteins that are present in the membrane. One is integral proteins, then another one are peripheral proteins. Now, integral proteins are the one which are present, which transverse the membrane like this. These are integral proteins. This is the outer surface of the cell, and this is the inner side, that is the cytoplasm. And the proteins which transverse this membrane, that are integral proteins. Now these integral proteins can pass the membrane once, or it can pass the membrane several times. So based on that, integral proteins are also categorized as single transmembrane, and multiple transmembrane proteins. Let's discuss how it can be single and multiple. Let's make this a big structure and discuss. See, this is the membrane. If the protein is passing the membrane once, then this is your single transmembrane. If the protein is passing the membrane several times, like this, this is your N terminal, C terminal of the protein, then this is your multiple transmembrane protein. Other than that, we have second category, that are your peripheral proteins. Peripheral proteins are the ones which are present on the periphery like this. These are your peripheral proteins. And the structure of this membrane was given by Nicholson and Sackler. And they call this model as fluid mosaic model. Now, why it is called as a fluid? Fluid because the proteins, they are free to transverse laterally. That's why it is called as the fluid. And mosaic because there are presence of many proteins in the membrane, like we have peripheral proteins, we have integral proteins, so that's why it is a fluid mosaic model. Next, like this is the cell membrane which is present in both the plant and the animal cell. Now the plant cell, they have additional cell wall, that additional membrane, that is your cell wall. Now cell wall, it is made up of cellulose. We discuss about the cell wall. Here also we have two categorization of cell wall. One is the primary cell wall. The other one is the secondary cell wall. The primary cell wall, it is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose, and pectin, whereas the secondary cell wall, it is also made up of cellulose, but it has high content of cellulose. Also this is thick, this one is thin, and this is present in growing plants, the younger plants, or you can say the growing cells, whereas this one is present in fully grown cells. The basic function of cell wall is to provide the mechanical strength and resistance to the plant cell. we are coming to organelles. We have covered the cell membrane, the cell wall, the outer coverings. Now let's discuss about the organelles. So first of all, we'll discuss about the endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is in continuation with the nuclear envelope. Now, nuclear envelope has two membranes, the inner membrane and the outer. With the outer membrane, the endoplasmic reticulum is continuous. And then in the nuclear membrane, you have nucleopores that are present. Nucleopores, they have a function of transportation of mRNA outside of the nucleus and transport of certain proteins inside and outside of the nucleus. Now within ER we have certain regions, like there are certain rough regions that we call as rough endoplasmic reticulum. And why they are rough? Because of the presence of ribosomes that are attached on it. So ER has two categorization: rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The rough endoplasmic reticulum is rough because of the presence of ribosomes that are attached on it, whereas the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is the one which do not have the ribosomes attached to it. Now, what is the function of rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum? The rough endoplasmic reticulum, because of the presence of ribosomes on it, they have the function in the synthesis of protein. Whereas smooth endoplasmic reticulum, they have the function in lipid biosynthesis and detoxification. So the proteins are being synthesized in the ER. After the proteins that are being synthesized in the ER, they will move to the Golgi apparatus for packaging. So now we'll discuss about the Golgi apparatus. So Golgi apparatus was discovered by Camillo Golgi. Now the protein that is being synthesized by the ER, it will move to the Golgi. Now Golgi has this kind of structure. It has the cis phase and the trans phase. The one facing the ER is your cis phase. The other away from it is the trans phase. And this disc type structure is basically your cis turning. Now the protein that is being synthesized in the ER will move to the cis phase of the Golgi, then it will move to the middle phase, and then it will move to the trans in the vesicles. And the Golgi has the main function in the packaging of protein. One is the packaging of protein, then another function is the post-translational modification. What is post-translational modification is? There are certain modifications or the addition of your carbohydrate moiety to the protein that we call as a post-translational modification. While the protein is moving in vesicles from ER to Golgi, there would be addition of carbohydrates to your proteins, which would help the protein for its signaling purpose and its movement purpose. That where the protein will actually go will determine by the post-translational modification that would take place in the Golgi. And after the protein will exit from the trans phase, and whatever be the fate of the protein, whether it has to go to the cell membrane or it has to go to the lysosomes, it will go there. And every protein has a different fate. It will, some proteins will go to the membrane, some proteins will go to some other organelle, and that is basically determined by the post-translational modification that would take place over here, the pattern of post-translational modification that would take place in the Golgi. Next, let's discuss about the other organelle, that is your mitochondria. Now, mitochondria, as we know, it is known as the powerhouse of the cell. Why it is known as the powerhouse of the cell? Because it has a role in the synthesis of ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate. Now, ATP is basically, if you look into the mechanism of ATP synthesis, it's very complex, but to short it, in a way, like we have the glucose. Glucose is basically broken down into pyruvate by the process of glycolysis, and pyruvate then is converted into acetyl coenzyme A. The acetyl coenzyme A then undergoes into the citric acid cycle, which we know as the Krebs cycle also, and that takes place in mitochondria. After the citric acid cycle, whatever the NADH and FADH2 that are being formed, that are converted to ATP with the liberation of water molecules. These are converted into ATP that we call as the oxidative phosphorylation. So that's how the ATP production will take place in the mitochondria. But first of all, let's discuss about the structure of the mitochondria. Now, mitochondria is a double membrane structure. It is a double membrane and also it has its own circular DNA. इसके अलावा circular DNA भी खुद का है, double membrane structure है, and there are presence of ribosomes. अगर ribosomes भी present है, circular DNA भी है, तो it means it can make proteins. So certain proteins are being formed in mitochondria. Not all the proteins, but some of the proteins that are required by mitochondria that are being synthesized in the mitochondria as well. So it's a circular DNA, it has ribosome, it's a double membrane structure. Let's look into the structure. It's a double membrane structure. The outer membrane and the inner membrane is basically folded. The inner membrane is folded. This is the outer membrane. The inner folded membrane. And these folds are basically known as the cisternae. And also the space between the two membranes is your intermembranal space. And the fluid that is present inside this is your matrix, that we call your matrix of the mitochondria. And there are many proteins that are present in your outer membrane, and there are certain proteins that are present in the inner membrane, and all of which have different role in the formation of ATP in during oxidative phosphorylation. So this oxidative phosphorylation process, it takes place in mitochondria, whereas the pyruvate and the glycolysis part takes place in the cytosol of the cell.